Today we're going to take a look at the insert zoom feature in PowerPoint. Wouldn't it be great to have an introduction slide or summary slide and then you zoom in to the different parts of your presentation? That ensures that you don't lose sight of the topics, and it also allows you to quickly zoom into the various sections. Imagine this. You spent days trying to come up with the best visualization for your annual report. You sat with every team member and manager and you took them through the three different visualizations and you asked them to vote for their favorite. The winner will show up in the final report. Now the voting is complete. You're presenting, and this is one way the presentation can go. Here's option A. This is option B and option C, and the winner is option B. Now imagine you discovered Zoom before you gave your presentation. Let's present. Here's option A, where we use a column chart for both actual and variance. This is option B, where we keep attention on actual values, and option C, where the variance is shown above the bars and arrows. And the winner is option B. Wow, Zoom also changed my enthusiasm. That's the added benefit. Now, let me show you how you can set it up. First off, I'm going to show you Zoom in its most basic form. The first thing you need to do whenever you use Zoom is to create all the slides you need for your presentation. So in this case, I just have these three slides that I'm presenting, and I'm going to add a new slide. That's where I want to have my Zoom. So right mouse click, new slide. Now let's just remove what's on the slide. Go to insert. Under the links category, you see Zoom, select slide zoom. Here you get a pop-up that shows the different slides in your presentation. So in this case, I'm going to select 2, 3, and 4, click on insert. What it inserts are actually links to those slides, and I can see the image of the slide. The image is actually live, so if you change anything on that slide, it's going to reflect in here. That's it. Let's go to presentation view and see what we get. Let's click on the first one. It zooms in to the first slide using this nice transformation. Let's click the mouse again. It goes to the second slide and the third slide. Now the presentation ended. There are some zoom features that you can control. For example, that ending of the presentation is something I don't want to happen. I'd rather go back to my zoom slide. You can control these under the zoom tab. There are two important options that you're probably going to need when you use Zoom. The first one is return to Zoom. So let's just activate this for these slides. So put a check mark for return to Zoom. Now let's go back to presentation mode and see what happens. Go into the second one, click the mouse again. It takes me back to slide zoom. So click, click, takes me back. In this specific case, I just want to go back to the Zoom view for the last slide. So I'm going to remove the check mark from the first and the second ones. The other important option that you're probably going to need is to remove the Zoom background. So in this case, I have a white slide on a white background. We don't really notice it. Let's just change this one to gray. We removed Zoom background. It's kind of like a no fill setting for the slide. And all we have to do is select a slide, click on Zoom background. That's it. This also gives you a chance to get creative with your presentations. Let's just go and insert a round shape on there. So let's just put this shape on the first Zoom slide. Change the shape fill to a light blue color. Take away the shape outline. Now, this is not fancy. Don't judge me on the colors. Okay, it's just to show you the possibilities that you have with Zoom. You can also change the size of these slides. So if I find this one is too small, I can just drag it and make it bigger. Let's go back to presentation mode. We get this nice zoomed in effect, and we can still see our blue shape in there. It blends in perfectly once it zooms. So that was Zoom in its most basic form. Let's take this a step further and make a more interesting presentation. Add a new slide and let's change the background to have a picture. So I'm going to select a picture from file, and I have one sitting on my desktop. I'll use this, click on insert. Now you can bring in any type of images you like to your PowerPoint presentation. So I have these three images sitting on another PowerPoint. I'm just going to cut them and paste them in my PowerPoint here. So in PowerPoint, you have a lot of picture formatting options. What I've already done to these pictures is I've cropped them and I've taken away the background, right? So PowerPoint in itself can be like a mini Photoshop, right? You don't have all those options, but you have enough to make a nice looking presentation. So let's just tilt the first one a little bit, thus arrange the objects a little bit nicer on the slide. Now let's go back to Insert Zoom, select Slide Zoom, and select our three slides that we want to present. Now we get to organize them the way we like on the slide. So I can tilt them a little bit, position them the way I like, make them a bit larger to make them fit better, and remove the Zoom background. So let's do the same thing for the second and the third one. Okay, so this looks good. Now let's check, when do we want to return back to Zoom? So when I'm presenting the first one, I don't want to return to Zoom. Second one, not return to Zoom. Only on the last one, I want to return to Zoom. Now what I want to do is then to show the winner. And the winner is option B. So what I'm going to do is to copy the slide that's going to be the winner. I'm just going to replicate it and paste it at the end. And I'm going to make a separate Zoom for this one. I can even change the text on the slide to say this is the winner, but I'm just going to leave that out for now. So let's go back to Insert Slide Zoom, insert the winner slide on the bottom here. I don't want people to see who the winner is already, right? I want to hide that. I can do that by selecting Change Image. I can select the image from File, Online Pictures, or let's just select one from the Office icon. So let's just scroll down, select the first one under Celebration, click on Insert. It has this border around it, so let's go back to Zoom, Zoom Border, and select No Outline. The other thing is to make sure that we return back to Zoom once we present the winner. So let's go and activate that as well. Let's go to presentation mode. So this is our option A, this was option B, this is option C. We go back to Zoom and the winner is option B. And when we click again, we go back to Zoom. That's the end of our presentation, which is nicer than that black screen. Until now, we were adding Zoom to single slides. But what if we have more information on them? The advantage of Zoom is that you can use it on your bigger presentation. So you can zoom in on a specific section. It gives you a nicer ability to move around your presentation than just like scrolling through the slides. I'm going to expand on this example and show you how you can set that up. So let's add a new slide, type in more info on A. You can add as many slides as you want in between. So let's do the same thing for B. Let's add more info on B. How is that going to impact our current slide zoom? So let's test that. Let's go back to presentation mode. I see more info on A, but then it just jumps to B, C, and then it ends the presentation. Like the zoom is broken because I didn't select return to zoom after presenting that one slide. So it just goes through the slides in its usual way. The moment you have more than one slide to present, you need to work with sections. That's the other great thing about PowerPoint. Sections are super easy to add. So all you have to do is go between two slides, right mouse click, and select Add Section. This last slide was the winner. We can call it Section Winner. For that last slide, I didn't add any additional information, so it's just going to be its own section. Let's just call it Section C. For the other sections, we have more slides, so these two slides belong together. Right mouse click, add section, call it Section B. And let's do the same thing for the first section and call it Section A and press enter. So we have the different sections set up. Let's go back to our Zoom slide. Let's remove the type of Zoom we had before, and now we're going to insert a different type of Zoom. Select Section Zoom. So we can see Section Zoom activated because we've added sections to the presentation and we can see them here. So let's just add in the sections that we want. I'm just going to pick these three sections, click on Insert. It looks the same as what we had before, but it's not really the same because it has the entire section behind that Zoom level. So I'm just going to quickly organize them, take away the Zoom background and make them fit a little bit nicer. Now notice this, notice that it has the number of slides that are behind this and there's an arrow back because return to Zoom is automatically activated. So you can talk about each section independently and then return to Zoom. So now when we click this, remember there was another slide behind it. We're still in Zoom mode and we go back. We go to B, there's another slide behind it and we go back. The last one just had the one slide, so we just go back. So the moment you've activated sections though, you're free to add in as many slides as you want in between. So let's go to section B, add a new slide, even more info, go back to our Zoom slide, go to presentation mode, and let's take a look. Even more info is already there. So that's how Zoom works in PowerPoint for Office 365 and 2019. Think about which presentations you could apply this to. Let me know in the comments below. Also, let me know if you like the winner of our visualization contest. Learning a few tips and tricks here and there can majorly improve our productivity at work. Now, if that's something you like to do, so if you want to improve your productivity in office applications or other areas, check out Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with more than 25,000 classes in design, business, and more. For example, if you want to improve your productivity, whether in your personal or professional life, check out Thomas Frank's Productivity Masterclass. Once you sign up for premium membership, you get unlimited access so you can join any of the classes that are right for you and your goals. Whether you want to fuel your curiosity, creativity, or career, Skillshare is the perfect place to keep you learning and improving. Now, a subscription to Skillshare is also super affordable. An annual subscription is less than $10 a month, and with that, you get to join more than 7 million students who are learning on the platform. Use the link in the description to get a 2-month free trial. Many thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to get updates when I post new videos here. Ending.